Last week we were supposed to pick a verse out of Proverbs 12 and memorize it and apply it to our lives. I like the verse Proverbs 18 because it says, a man in need of discernment openly proclaims his wrath, but an astute man hides his own dishonor. Proverbs 10, a righteous man has compassion on the lives of his cattle, but the affections of the ungodly are without mercy.
Chapter 12, verse 15. He whose looks are kind, he will show mercy, but he who attends in the gates shall afflict souls.
Proverbs 12, 11. He who works his own land will be satisfied with bread, but those who pursue vain things are in need of discernment. What that means is if you work your land, then when there's a famine, then you will have food.
What is cell phone?
I got Proverbs 12, verse 31. In the ways of righteousness there is life, but the ways of remembering wrong unto death.
I got Proverbs 12, 1. A man who loves instruction loves perception, but a man who hates correction hates discernment. And I've been trying to listen to my dad's instruction and apply it to my life this week.
Proverbs 12, verse 20. There are those who wound with a sword as they speak, but the tongues of the wise heal.
Proverbs 12, 18. A man without discernment immediately proclaims his wrath, but an astute man hides his own dishonor.
Proverbs 12, 17. The ways of undiscerning men are right in their own eyes, but a wise man hearkens to counsels. And I was thinking about how much humility goes with being wise. How if a wise man hearkens to counsels.
Proverbs 12, 22. There is deceit in the heart of a man who devises evil things, but those who counsel peace will be glad. So I try to do things that make things more peaceful in our home.
Proverbs 12, 1. He who loves instruction loves perception, but he who hates correction is without discernment.
Proverbs 12, 1. He who loves instruction loves perception, but he who hates correction is without discernment.
For next week was the verse that we read today in chapter 13, verse 26. About a father loving his son and not straying the rod or correcting him. You tell a lot of times that your father or your parents corrected you, whether it was the rod or just correcting you or telling you what you're doing wrong, what you're learning about.